Your Excellency, the Speaker of the Kaduna State House of Assembly, the former Governor of Cross River State, my brother and one of the best governors we've ever had, Governor Donald Duke, His Eminence the Sultan of Sokoto, my brother, His Royal Highness, the Emir of Kano, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to observe all protocol. I have about 50 slides to present in 30 minutes, so I'm going to be very fast. I want to join my colleague, the Deputy Governor, to welcome you all to Kaduna for the second edition of the Kaduna Economic and Investment Summit. What I would like to do in the next 25 minutes is to present to you what happened last year since we had the last summit. What have we done? Because one of the issues we are determined about in the Kaduna State Government is for this not to be a talk shop. We hope it will be an annual event, but we also hope that every year we report to you what we have achieved in the previous year while unveiling the plans for the succeeding years. So we'll give you a brief overview of 2016 and then where Kaduna State is today, what we are doing for 2017 and where we hope to take the state going forward. I'll finally end with a sales speech, giving you reasons why you should invest in Kaduna. Next slide. So what happened in 2016 since the last summit? We have tried to continue our job of streamlining government. With the support of the State House of Assembly, we have advanced in establishing a solid legal and regulatory framework for investments in the state, while leveraging the participation of the private sector in key sectors. Last year, we unveiled the State Development Plan and created agencies to drive it. Today, we will go further by God's grace, but these initial steps were necessary to keep the state on a sound footing, take us out of recession that has gripped the entire country. This slide summarizes what we've done in various areas. In the area of the economy, we firmly established KADIPA and staffed it. We established the Kaduna Internal Revenue Service, a new agency with centralized functions for tax collection. We also abolished the Ministry of Land, Survey and Country Planning and established the Kaduna Geographic Information Service as a one-stop agency on all land matters. We have before the State House Assembly a mortgage foreclosure bill that will make it easy for residents of Kaduna State to have access to 15 to 20 year mortgages to buy their own houses. In the area of security and justice, we have bills before the State House of Assembly to advance the justice environment. The Vigilance Service Bill, Witness Protection, Administration of Criminal Justice, a new penal code which all the 19 northern states adopted, a Peace Commission Bill to work on peace building as well as regulate religious preaching. We have this at the various stages at the State House of Assembly. In the social area, we have a new pensions reform law. We established a primary health care agency, community and social development agency, which is supported by the World Bank. Our child rights bill and schools management bill is before the State House of Assembly, while the water and sanitation law has been passed. In the areas of governance, we've continued with our reforms of the public service, but passed key legislation in the areas of public procurement, fiscal responsibility, as well as transforming our Ministry of Budget and Planning into a Planning and Budget Commission. This is before the State House of Assembly. We've also sent a bill to reform the local government system, and by God's grace, this year we'll have local government elections using electronic voting. It will be the first time any state in Nigeria does it. So So what about capital projects? We have completed or advanced to near completion many capital projects that we announced last year. We've renovated over 400 out of our 4,000 primary schools. We've supplied street lighting all across our metropolis. Work on the 300-bed hospital has advanced. We're upgrading primary health centers such that every pregnant woman will have access to prenatal, natal, and antenatal and postnatal care within 5-kilometer radius. We are rehabilitating secondary schools, constructing township roads, intercity and rural roads. And last year, we delivered fertilizer to our farmers in cooperation with Flour Mills of Nigeria at 4,000 naira per bag without any subsidy. And the results are clear. Agriculture is booming in the rural parts of Kaduna. We hope this year to commission the Zaria Water Project, and we've also undertaken drainage works all across the metropolis. So this is more or less what we've done in the last 1 year. But where are we going? Where is the Kaduna of tomorrow? Our vision is to make Kaduna great again, make it a state where there is abundant economic opportunities and prosperity, social inclusion, peace and security, good governance, and improved quality of lives of all the citizenry. It was Development Plan 2016 to 2020, which focus on jobs, social justice, and prosperity. I will just go through the outlines of that plan, which we presented last year. It's a 5-year plan, and it provides a strategic framework to realize our vision, to plan and finance priority projects, as well as monitor results on the ground. It was also a platform for us to engage with our citizens, and indeed, most of the plan was crowdsourced. We put drafts on the web and got feedback from our citizens. The result was a plan based on two foundations and two areas. The first foundation is one of governance, centered around citizens' engagement. We hold town hall meetings regularly with our people. We establish service delivery institutions, and we are trying to improve our human capacity to deliver. The second foundation is security and justice, to prevent crimes, protect lives and property, and introduce efficiency and fairness in justice administration. But our main focus is on two pillars. The first, economic development, particularly in sectors where we believe we have competitive advantage, like agriculture, mining, and manufacturing. We're also looking at supporting sectors, growing our financial services sector and our telecom sector. On this foundation is infrastructure, the enablers that will enable economic growth. And then in the areas of social welfare, education, health, we are promoting culture and entertainment and focus on female empowerment. So our hope is that in the year 2020, Kaduna will be a destination for business investment and the food basket of northern Nigeria, where all citizens have access to quality healthcare and education, live and move freely without fear of harm, under a transparent and accountable government with a highly motivated and efficient civil service. I'll now look at the pillars in more detail very, very quickly. In the area of economic development, one important pillar is to reduce our reliance on Federation account by growing our internally generated revenue. This we have succeeded in doing to some extent because we moved our internally generated revenue by more than 50% within 1 year without increasing any taxes from 13 billion to 18 billion. We've broadened taxpayer registration and collection, and indeed in 2016 we added over 400,000 new taxpayers to our taxpayer database. We have improved the pace at which we do land allocation, and we are signing certificates of occupancy at a very, very fast rate of over 300 CFOs every week. We've maintained our capital to recurrent expenditure ratio at 60-40, and also maintained a sustainable debt position in line with the debt management office criteria. We've continued to work on eliminating waste and under other unjustifiable expenditure. We've worked on improving economic growth through investment in economics and social infrastructure. Today, by God's grace, we'll unveil our infrastructure master plan for the next 30-something years. We'll also unveil today sector implementation plans, because for each of these sectors, we got the ministries, departments and agencies to develop implementation plans for the purpose of monitoring. Now let me speak a little bit about the infrastructure master plan. As I said, later today we'll unveil this master plan, which looks at the infrastructure needs of Kaduna State from 2017 to 2050. This master plan covers both economic and social infrastructure, and it identifies about 300 key projects that we need to implement over the next 30 years. And we hope it will be a guide not only for our administration, but for succeeding administrations to make decisions on land use, budgeting, zoning, as well as subdivisions. We are motivated to produce this plan to link the state development plan to actual steps that we need to take to bring it to fruition. Today, we hope that this plan will be available for all of you and the citizens of Kaduna State to comment upon. It is a green paper, it's a consultation paper for which we hope we'll take feedback before concluding and publishing it. We hope to finance the plan through the budget, public debt, public-private partnerships, as well as external support. The plan has five objectives, and the objective number five, I think, is the most important in my opinion: to create a conducive environment for public-private participation in infrastructure project development. We cannot do this alone. We need the private sector. And our job is to create the environment that will give private sector the comfort to do this.